Can I get a motion to revise the agenda for other business, please?
Motion.
Motion by Kevin, second by Andrea. Any objection? I see none, so move. Under other business, we had a... Something to talk about with the legislative session, I want to refer to my attorney, Ms. Denise.
Thank you. We had received word of House Bill 294, right, I think the day before it was being considered in the legislature. There wasn't enough time to make a comment, there wasn't a procedure to make any comment, and there wasn't time to solicit input from the board before it was voted on at the legislature. So we have a recommendation to the board that we let you know about this bill, and I know that everybody has been apprised of it over the last couple of days, and give us time to research what steps, if any, we might recommend the board take. Y'all are fiduciaries of the system, and we want to take careful attention to what that means and what steps we ought to pursue, but we want to do it wisely, so we need some time to do the research.
Any other business, any questions?
Yes, sir. Yeah, as y'all know, Amy usually represents Treasury on the board today, but I wanted to comment on this issue. The last 2 days, I've been in New York meeting with our rating agencies. We had meetings with S&P, Moody's, and Fitch. And as you know, that's important because the rating that these rating agencies gives us affects our interest rate, the interest rate the taxpayers have to pay. So if they lower your rating, you pay more in interest, which means you don't have as much money to pay for new troopers or to run higher education or to build roads. One of the concerns, probably the biggest concern, certainly among the top three that the rating agencies have with our credit rating, is our retirement system, the unfunded accrued liability that we all know about. And before I go there, I want to congratulate you on your rate of return. It's really, really good. And I was careful to point that out to the rating agencies. But we've got about a $19 billion unfunded accrued liability among the four retirement systems that are backed by the full faith and credit of the state. The rating agencies, at least the analyst of each rating agency that is assigned to your state, knows as much about Louisiana as we do. The analyst assigned to your state reads all the papers, looks at all the videos and the television, they read all the blogs, so they're very, very up to date about what's going on. The subject of Act 290, Senate Bill 294, came up with the rating agencies. And we had a very long discussion about the state's unfunded accrued liability and how we're going to deal with it. This is what I told the rating agencies. We need to get the facts. And I'm glad to hear, and I hope the board will support this approach. I personally don't have the facts. I know what I have read in media reports. I'm not suggesting they're wrong. I just think it's important because of our fiduciary duty to do our own analysis. I would like to know a couple of things. I would like to know first how many people this impacts. The provision in SB 294. I would like to know who they are. Now, frankly, it doesn't, to me, the personalities don't matter. Doesn't matter whether you're a prince or pauper or a king or a pawn. Personalities don't matter. But the people who the bill impacts have a right to due process and a right to come speak to the board if they want to and say, here's our side of the story. I'd like to know the cost. And that And I'm asking these things so I can have something to report back to the rating agencies with, because I was flying blind up there when they're asking questions. I'd like to know the cost of 294. I'd like to know if 294 gives special treatment to anyone, how much it would cost to give the same treatment to all of our people. Okay? I would like to know who sponsored the amendment in committee to enable them to come and explain the intent of the amendment and why it was done. I think that's only fair. I noticed in one of the media reports, Senator Morrell was, I think he's the sponsor of the bill. JP is an honorable man, a good man, I've known him for years. I would like to invite JP to come talk to us and say, here's what happened, here's what the intention was. I'd like to know about the legality of the bill. Can you do an amendment dealing with a retirement issue that's supposed to be advertised? Can you do it in the conference committee when you haven't advertised it? I don't know the answer to that. Was the amendment germane to the bill? These are the kind of issues, and that's on a must-have list, not exhaustive. These are the kind of issues I think we need to get to the bottom of. I'd also like to know what our remedies are. Litigation. Seek legislative relief. Has special treatment been given? Maybe it hasn't. But we need to get to the bottom of this. And I really need, I want us to be accurate more than quick. But I'd like to be able to report back to the rating agencies that we're on this. We understand the issue. We're serious about our retirement systems. We're serious about funding our retirement systems. We're serious about reducing this $19 billion unfunded accrued liability, and we take it seriously, and we're going to get to the bottom of it. And that's what I wanted to come out and say. Okay? Because it has ramifications greater than, as important as the ramifications are to us here, it has ramifications that are hard. Okay? Do you have a feel, Counselor, how long this will take?
We intend to have some type of report at our next board meeting. It'll be a couple of months.
Okay.
Is that soon enough, John?
Yes. That gives me, I can report to the rating agencies. If you could, would consider, if the board would respectfully consider inviting the people that I mentioned, to, if they would like to come talk to us. I think that's important. There are always two sides to every story. And I don't know whether, for example, Senator Morrell wanted to come, but I would. He was there. I'd like to hear from Charles Hall. I've heard, I don't know if it's accurate, that Charles came up with the numbers for this. I'm not second guessing his numbers, but I want to have somebody go back and look at the cost. It's been reported, what, $300,000?
Correct.
We need to double check that.
John, the proper procedure there is that the legislative actuary
right.
would confirm those numbers by our systems actuary, and I'm not sure that has been done, but those are the kind of things we need to follow up on and be sure that all the steps that were intended to assure the proper fiduciary was handled were handled.
Well, if we can invite Charles to come and give us a report as well and walk us through it, but I do think it's very important we get to the facts first. But having said that, I mean what I said. If somebody has been given treatment that they're not entitled to, that's unequal, then the personalities mirror out. And I think they are the most members of the board. Everybody's supposed to be treated the same. But we've got to see the facts first.
Well said. We need a motion.
We'll take note of this request from a board member, and we'll make certain to follow up on that for next time.
And the next board meeting would be in September. Next call of board meeting would be in September.
Third Wednesday of September.
Would it be possible, if we had that report sooner, to consider a special board meeting?
I see no reason not to.
Dictated by our research, I guess.
Okay. Yeah.
I really think it's important we we've addressed this issue. I've gotten the same phone calls y'all have gotten.
The sooner you can have the information, you can respond to those rating agencies.
And I need to respond to the rating agencies and the people we represent. I know we'd like an answer to.
Yes, sir.
That's the only other business we had today, Mr. Chairman.
All right.